It's your choice.
Let's see if this thing really works.
Man who saved Mummy. Thank you.
The hanged man is always watching. As if he had aught better to do.
That a hanged man, I see. Master Quentin must think you're important. It was a good thing you done today, getting rid of those bastards. If you hadn't come when you did, I'd be on my way to Ash by now. Along with the others. Poor buggers.
These others, was there a dominant among them? A dominant of fire?
Might have been, yeah. Royalists seem to think there was, anyhow.
A thin bloke all swallowed up in his robes like one of great Grieger's churchmen.
Do you recall anything else about him?
Only that he weren't alone. Was a young maid who went wherever he did, including the church, and wherever the royalists dragged them both off to before you got here.
I see. Thank you.
That's all you can remember. Think hard.
Ah. Master Quinton took a liking to you, I see. And there I was, thinking you were in bed with Sid. Wonder what Gav will have to say about this. Speaking of whom, if you see him, tell him thanks for looking after us. Now, what can I help you with?
I'm searching for a dominant of fire. Gav seems to think he might have taken refuge here.
We see a lot bearers around these parts. But I do seem to recall one who commanded the flame. Now, whether or not that makes him a dominant, I can't say. But the Waludas certainly took a keen interest in the poor sod.
Did you get a look at him?
Didn't have a chance. One of the other bearers might have, though.
Thank you. I wonder if Sid's found anything.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me that scowl means you've got good news. So, a shady lad with a hood and his equally shady lass. Not much to go on, but...
But?
I've been thinking, if our friend is a dominant, why not just burn the royalists to a crisp? There's a reason he's holding back, and I reckon he has something to do with his partner.
What makes you say that?
One of the villagers I talked to said the two were separated. If the Waludas have her, our dominants like to think twice before starting any fires. Whoever he is, he's shown himself to have a level head. He's careful, cunning, and he doesn't want to be found. This could spell trouble for us and the Royalists both. Still, it'll be a whole lot worse if we set off after them with bleary eyes and empty bellies. There should be a pair of pallets waiting for us back at the inn. Shall we? Now, about those beds.
Beds? I seem to recall your request being to spend the night. And for that, the floor will more than suffice.
Better than a wet rock, I suppose. My thanks, Quentin. Next time you're at the Hideaway, our floor's all yours.
No need for thanks, Sid. This isn't an act of charity.
You don't say.
In exchange for my floor, I shall be requiring your services. The Royalists saw fit to erect a barricade across the road south when they occupied the village, and failed to remove it when they left. I expect it to be gone before you leave.
As you wish. Well, that took longer than expected. First time dismantling the barricade? It gets easier, don't worry.
I won't.
Other wait?
No more waiting.
The road south, then? Unless...
I know of another shortcut. You should be so lucky. Take the care that have posted sentries to prevent any unwelcome surprises. At least I would have.
Well, you should know.
Fuck! just what Lady said.
Even when it isn't crawling with royalists.
I don't care who else is in there.
Much as I enjoy battering down the front door, I hazard this endeavor will require a bit more tact.
There's an old sluice that empties under the bridge. It should see us through to the lower levels of the Care. Cid. We both know why I'm here. But what is it that you want? Why would you risk your life for a handful of outcasts? If anyone ever learned what you've been doing with their property...
They'd have my head in a box. But this isn't just about dominance and bearers, it's about all of us. What I want is to build a place where it doesn't matter what you are, but who you are. But our world isn't ready for a place like that. So, until it is, I use the power I've been given to show people there is hope.
Tell me about this, Benedicta.
The best and worst decision I ever made. Don't underestimate her, Clive. A fight with her icon is not one you're likely to walk away from.
Garuda. Warden of the Wind.
Hey.
Thalan has fallen. The eastern territories all but belong to the orcs.
I'll have my men ready to depart by noon.
Don't bother.
But what of the mines? Without adamantite...
The blight would have engulfed the mines ere long. Besides, you already have your orders.
Yes, my liege.
The dark swallows more of the realm with each passing day. The land starved of the ether that gives it life. And as the fringes fade, the people flock to the mother crystals, desperate for their blessing. The war we wage for possession of that blessing, it breaks us from within, hastening us to our own destruction.
And so you do what must be done.
I unite the dominance, that we may bring an end to the strife, and found a new order to see us unto tomorrow. The world must be restored, and I will see it so.
You might have already had Sidolphus not betrayed us.
Him again. Lust you still for his embrace?
But... of course not, my liege. I serve you, and you alone.
I remember well the day you first entered these halls. Your pale hand pressed into his, as if it would never let go.
That was a long time ago. Yours is the only hand I need. Now and always.
Soon, my dear. Soon all will know whose hand it is that keeps them from falling into the darkness.
Hold me, my liege. Never let me go.
One of our sentries has failed to report, m'lady. Your orders?
Pull the men back inside the care, Geralf.
He is here, then.
Have them lead Sid and his little pet to the chapel. I shall entertain them there. So you've come for me, after all.
Teach me sometime.
We should start with the dungeons. They may be holding the bearers there.
Sound plan. As long as we keep ourselves on this side of the bars.
In here. They're all empty.
And? You're gonna give up?
Sid, this gate.
Need some help.
Did you hear that?
Unfortunately, yes.
Great. They already be in the care. Wait, what?
good news, lad.
Your search is over.
It's over.
So, where to next?
This door only leads to more royalists. We'd better find another one.
Take your pick.
How about a window?
Show off. Well, we found the Imperial garrison. Right where the royalists left them. Didn't know what hit them.
the alarm.
All this bloody running. After them. They were expecting us.
You don't say.
That's enough.
What the hell happened here? A little late for prayer, isn't it?
Do I seem so desperate as to grovel at the feet of a false god? I was waiting for you.
Not for too long, I hope. All this for a midnight chat. Well, let's chat then. Where are the men and women you took from Lostwing?
You mean where's the Dominant? Well, Lute shall be requiring his services indefinitely. Come back to me, Sidolphus. I need you. Think of all the things we can create together. The world that we can build.
You need me? Your king needs me. I'm all for building a new world. Just not his. That bastard's dreams are as twisted as his promises are false. And I want no part of them.
King Barnabas saved you, and this is how you speak of him. Have you no shred of loyalty?
What? To a leader who'd use me? Like he uses you.
You know nothing of me, Sidolphus.
You're right. I don't know who you are anymore. Or what you want. I only know what you used to say. That you were tired of running. That you just wanted to be free. Free of it all. You weren't lying to me then, so what changed? What made you think you had to sacrifice who you were to get what you wanted?
Sacrifice? I use my talents to my advantage, and you would tell me there is shame in that?
If there's no shame, then why do you feel so sorry for yourself?
A rousing speech, Lord Commander. I was a fool to believe you might have changed. The only person I feel sorry for is you! I can't do this anymore.
you would stand between our liege and his dream, then you leave me no choice. Goodbye, Sidolphus.
Stand back, Clive.
Finish them.
Well, Sid, the least is not pretty against one.
Not this time.
Sid, are you all right?
Do I look all right? Benedicta will be on her way to collect the Dominant, if she hasn't already. You can't afford to let them leave. Remember, she has wings, you don't.
What about you?
Before or after I catch my breath.
Sorry. Come on, Torgal.
Grow wings yet? Then you'd better start climbing those stairs. I'll sit guard here. Do you want her to take the Dominant? Move!
Somewhere.
The withdrawal has been signaled.
Further. Finally.
I confess I expected more from the old man. And less from you. This is the second time you've bested my sisters. Men of your talents are rare indeed. Why cost your lot with such undesirables? If it is the hearth you long for, you will find more than enough warmth under my wings.
You know exactly what I want. Hand over the Dominant, and I'll leave you in peace.
You would dare to make demands of me. Know your place, little lamb. Fool is the shepherd who heeds every bleat of the flock. And I will suffer yours no longer. Must I spell it out for you, Branded? No one is listening. No one at all! Come, little lamb, to the slaughter with you.
Sick of Toggle. Get him, boy.
Yeah! time to join your pet.
How did you do it? How
did you even survive? How?
The answer is simple, Benedicta. He was fighting for something he believed in.
Shut up! Why aren't you dead?
We've played your games. Now tell me where he is.
Who? What are you?
How'd you do that? Fuck me. I hope the bear has found a way out. Clive, this place is ready to collapse, and I'd rather not be here when it does. If your dominant started this fire, and I'm betting he did, he'll be long gone.
Damn it all. What was that?
I created a diversion as commanded, Your Grace. The villagers escaped in the confusion. As should we.
Yes.
Oh, look. Morning has broken. And here come the cavalry, itching to butcher the bastards who made them miss their morning gruel. Come on. If they catch us leaving a burning care, people might jump to conclusions.
Right.
Hector said you'd taken her power. You don't still have it, do you?
I think I do. This isn't the first time I've seen one of these. Perhaps I can use them as waymarks.
Stop there! Where did you two come from?
Keep your distance, boy. Let's get a point. We know what to do. Sick of Toggle.
Oh, it's only me!
Dummy Gap, are you trying to get yourself killed?
It's not me who's been playing with fire! You don't do things by halves, do you? This way. So if it wasn't you or him who freed the bearers, who was it?
Good question. Someone who didn't have their hands full fighting a bloody harpy, I guess. But what matters is they're safe. Something they wouldn't be had it not been for you, Gav.
Just doing me job, like. So, what about his dominant?
Gone. And after we were so close.
Well, I can track him.
Why would you?
Sid told us about your family. Lost me into Imperial Steel. Sometimes vengeance is the only thing that keeps you going.
Thank you.
Go safely, brothers.
I reckon he likes you.
She's gone. She's gone.
My lady, you have to hold on. We're going to get you.
Go on, go on, go on. What am I going to do? Barnabas.
How long to the coastal road?
At this pace, we won't make it by sunset.
He'll know. He'll cast me out like all the others. What am I going to do? What am I going to do?
My lady.
Here.
Fetch a good price, I reckon.
But we'd be doing the slavers a disservice if we didn't appraise her worth.
Stay away!
It's all right. They can't hurt you anymore. Come on, let's go home.
Is this it, Sidolphus? My punishment for not listening to you?
Sid.
Do you feel it too?
Garuda. By the flames.
She's drawn in too much ether. She can't control it. If Garuda isn't stopped, that vortex will swallow this whole forest, and us along with it.
And I'll stop her.
You'll stop her.
I heard it again. Someone is calling me.
Come in, lad. That doesn't mean you have to listen. Well, I should have gone with Gav. Clive, I don't think you understand. That's not just windy weather you're wandering into. Benedicta's rage knows no bounds. And that's on a good day. I don't want to know what's weighing inside that.
But I do. I have to find out. And I'm not turning back. There are so many.
Aye. One for every fragment of a mind.
There, boy! Get him! Sick of Torvald!
in there. I know it.
That?
The Dominant. The man who killed my brother.
Are you absolutely certain?
I've seen him every night for the past 13 years. Watched as the flames of his eye contact Joshua.
Cal!
Dead?
I'm here, and so's Togo. Don't worry about us. You've been waiting for this. Go!
Sid! Forgive me.
nothing. A monster. And I will not let you stand in my way!
control it, Clive! It is you, isn't it, Clive?
Stop this! Now!
Too nice is your problem. Bloody mess, this. The ghost you've been chasing, it was inside you all along. They'll be damned if I know what that means. Why did you have to listen to him? Benner! This can't be what you wanted, can it?
Bold, or desperate.
Will you engage him personally, Your Highness?
Of course.
Grigor's breath fill your wings.
Thank you.
Reform the cohorts.
At once.
Your Highness.
Saboteurs.
Their attacks are frequent and widespread, even in the Holy Capital.
The capital? What of my father? Is he...
Radiance is safe. But he has ordered the city guard strengthened. We can expect no reinforcements.
That is of no matter. The Emperor's safety is paramount. I shall deal with our enemies here.
First that trick with Garuda, then whatever the hell that other thing was. Didn't know you had it in you.
Do it.
Eh?
Kill me. It was me. I killed him. I killed Joshua. I killed them all. I'm a monster. And I deserve to die! So end it! End it now! Please! Please! Ah!
I reckon I can take you, if that's what you want. But first, I thought I'd give you the benefit of my timeless wisdom. It seems to me, you see, that since you're still breathing, you might as well make yourself useful. Get dressed. Pretty as you are, you're not my type. I'll, see you in the hall.
May as well hear what he has to say.
Don't go making me throw you back in there now, eh?
Well?
What's saying for you, dear? Scratches, right? Not bad, if I do say so myself. should last you a good while. That it? Fine.
And what do you want?
If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. You got out else? And be thankful you got that much. I reckon I can find a buyer. And be thankful you got that much. You're rubbing me blind, you know. You'll not find a better price than that. You got out else? I'll be thankful you got that much. Come again. Or don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
Finally crawled out of the crypt, eh? You look like it. Although I thank you for doing us the courtesy of covering up.
Don't.
Well, still have a bit of fight left in you? Then listen. I've arranged a meeting with Gav. In case you've forgotten, you're the one he's been putting his nose to work for.
For nothing.
Just listen. While you've been relaxing in your cell, Gav's been busy sniffing out your dominance. And according to his last report, he's picked up a scent. Gav's gone to a fair bit of trouble for you. The least you can do is hear the poor bugger out. He's going to meet us at the King's Fall. Pack your stuff. We'll leave as soon as you're ready.
I haven't noticed you stealing sips from that pot.
Yours is not a familiar face. Are you new to the hideaway, perchance?
You could say that.
Well then, allow me to welcome you. I am Harpocrates II Hyperboreus.
That's quite
a mouthful, I know. Which is why everyone here has taken to calling me simply Tomes. On account of the company I keep. And what varied company. I'm a collector, you see. Not of bijou and baubles, but of stories. The history and culture of these isles have ever been a source of endless fascination to me. But alas, my days of wandering the realm in search of new tales are far behind me. And so I've taken to sharing that which I've gathered with all who might listen. Perhaps you would care to listen. I have a few new notes that might interest you. I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. Now this, I believe you will find most interesting. What subject shall we consider today? Did you learn everything you needed?
Odin and Bahama had at it, by all accounts.
It's a wonder we didn't feel it here.
Not so long ago, this here was a thriving trade route. And then the blight came. The people left. And just like that, it was deserted. Making it the perfect little shortcut. Gab's waiting for us up ahead. Come on. Still feeling sorry for yourself?
Please.
Think about it, Clive. The rumours all point to... That was an Imperial signal. They shouldn't be here. The old fort's been abandoned for years. Our little chat can wait. I need to see what the bastards are up to. You go on ahead and meet up with Gab.
But we both know that...
No buts about it.
Over here. is it, boy?
After him! Don't let him escape!
Gaff! Who goes there?
This one's a deserter! Take his head!
Out of my way.
You made your choice!
Stay there, boy! Sick of Toggle! It's over!
You're late.
Gaff's in trouble.
What?
The Imperials are on his tail. We have to get to him before they do.
Understood. I'm here to even the odds. Any objections? I'll take the dragon. Take the cuckoo.
You know what to do.
Die, you bastard! All right, one down, one to go.
There, boy! Sick of Togo!
Come on.
Shit!
Give me your hand! Help me!
Help me! Help me, Clive!
I've got you.
Clive doesn't have your nose, I said. He'd stumble off a cliff, I said.
That's the trouble with a nose like mine. Can't help sticking it where it's not wanted. But if it wasn't for you two, my sniffing days would be over. Thank you. Truly.
So, what news?
Well, found out where your friend's heading, for one thing.
Gav, I...
Him and his mate are on their way to your old stomping ground, Rosaria. You should have seen what they did to the Imperials who tried to stop them.
Who killed the Phoenix? But we weren't alone, were we? There was the fellow you saw enter the whirlwind. I saw him too. You didn't dream it, Clive. He's out there.
But who is he?
Don't ask me. I don't bloody know. But I do know one thing. You're gonna find him and find out. After all, you swore an oath.
What?
You swore you'd avenge your brother's death. That you'd never rest until you'd hunted down the man responsible. So, find out if this man's responsible, and kill yourself if he's not.
Sid, I...
Don't thank me. Thank Gav.
Thank you, Gav.
Yeah, well, yeah.
No birds returning this year.
The deadlands have swallowed their roosts, like as not. We're running out of time.
We'll be in Rosaria in a day or two.
Back to where it all began. He must be stopped.
Spitting great gouts of fire he was, like a bleeding volcano.
Ever seen a volcano?
What? You think I'm having you on?
Clive! Your friend! She's awake!
Right.
Go to her, you fool.
Hmph.
Right, you lot. Enough slacking. Goots, come with me. Gav, go and get those wounds seen to.
Oh, give it to me straight. How long have I got?
So?
All in good time. Let's make ourselves scarce.
Jill.
Isn't the Moogle funny?
Let's get this fixed before someone does.
Then it really is you.
It is.
Clive, you're alive.
So are you. I still can't believe it. Are your wounds healed?
Yes. Talia told me what happened. You saved my life.
After nearly taking it, I had no idea. Forgive me, but how did you ever come to be there, Jill? Fighting for them.
The Iron Blood. They invaded not long after the news arrived about Phoenix Gate. Rosaria had lost her leaders. The duchy was in chaos. The Iron Kingdom saw our weakness and pounced upon it. They killed the men and captured the women.
And took you back to Ironhome.
I thought they meant to have their fun with me before the end. But the end never came. My powers awoke, and everything changed. It all happened so fast.
We were told that the Iron Blood had captured a dominant and planned to bring her on their latest crusade.
They gave me a choice. Fight for them on the battlefield, or see my countrywomen slaughtered.
And they call us dominants.
What? What happened, Clive? What happened at Phoenix Gate?
It was me. I killed Joshua.
No, that's not true. I know you. You wouldn't do that.
It's the truth. I changed into him again. Not long ago. The second Icon of Fire. The one responsible.
Clive.
When I think back to that night. The hooded man, he spoke to me. What did he say?
Francis.
We have found you. What did he mean?
Clive, we should go back there, to Phoenix Gate. I need to know what really happened, and so do you. You need to know for certain. And if what you told me is true, and you did what you said you did, then we will face it together.
Jill, I... All right.
You'll be needing a change of clothes, then. Out you go, your lordship. We wouldn't want you getting overexcited.
Sorry.
I'll see you soon, then, Clive.
I should be ready, too. We've a long journey ahead of us.
I'll come down as soon as I've got changed, Clive. I thought I told you to make yourself scarce. Your friend needs to get dressed.
Let's get this fixed before someone...
We're looking at half a dozen, maybe more.
Their bunks are made up.
What do you want?
To say farewell. We're leaving.
Good decision. Better that than buried out there in the black. You've got a lot to thank that girl for, you know.
I know. And I will.
Now, what do you really want? We both know you don't come here for conversation. Find a better price than that. Off you go, then. And best of luck.
I should probably say thank you to Gav, too.
Make it quick. So, will it be? Last you a good while. Yeah, that should do you. And
you're gonna buy some, be quick about it. You got out else?
Can I see I'm busy here?
What do you want?
Not bad, if I do say so myself.
Curl dragged in. If you're gonna buy some, be quick about it. I reckon I can find a buyer.
Isn't the Moogle funny?
They even have a Moogle. I've never seen one in the flesh. I'm sure it's said in my father's bestiary that they live deep in the forest, and that they never reveal themselves to humans. Nectar, you say? Clive. So it would seem. That sounds... painful.
Best get this fixed before someone doesn't...
We're looking at half a dozen.
We just don't have enough teams to follow every lead.
Good day. Or... wish to study the tomes?
Ah, a new face, and dare I hope, a willing pair of hands. The fat chocobo is a demanding mistress, and we are too few to keep her on her feet. Might I persuade you to deliver a meal or two to souls in need of sustenance? For your trouble, I can offer you the contents of my strongbox and my enduring gratitude.
I don't see why not.
Marvelous. And who exactly do I have the honor of addressing?
Clive.
Delighted to make your acquaintance, Clive. I'm Kenneth, and mine are the weary shoulders upon which the weight of this fine establishment rests. Now, I have three hungry customers awaiting their victuals. Take these if you would, and be careful. They're hot.
Hot meal. How long has it been? Food.
I was hoping it might be. Well, doesn't this look fine? Thank you, lad. You're new, aren't you? Kenneth's running you ragged already, I expect, the old rascal.
Well, he did say he'd give me something for my trouble.
And so he should. We're not slaves anymore. Well met, lad, and keep up the good work.
Kenneth is a miracle worker.
Here.
Oh, my thanks. I hope you do not think me lazy for waiting to be served like a lord. Only my former master did not use me kindly, you see. You left me half lame, truth be told. But Sid took me in nonetheless. Now, the hideaway is the home I never knew, and a mighty fine one at that.
Just seeds and soil.
Your food.
Just a moment. I need to finish this. I won't be a burden. I'm of no use to anyone as I am, but maybe if I can master this.
All right, but see that you eat it before it gets cold.
Of course. Thank you.
That's the last one. I'd better let Kenneth know.
All done, I presume? Splendid.
They were bearers. All three of them. Not slaves waiting upon their master's pleasure, but men waiting to be fed like equals.
Indeed. Equality is the very cornerstone upon which our little community is founded. Beyond these walls, we are scorned as slaves. Speaking only when spoken to, eating only what scraps our masters deign to give us. The first hot meal here is the first many will have known. In the hideaway, we are free. Truly free to speak as we please, when we please, and to eat what and when we desire. More than reason enough to trust in Sid's vision, wouldn't you say? Now, I promised you something for your trouble, did I not? The contents of my strongbox are yours to do with as you will. Thank you, Clive. Do come and visit me again, won't you?
You! Newcomer! I need help.
What's the matter?
It's my assistant. She left to gather soil, and I've seen nothing of her since. I cannot concentrate one whit for fear of what might have happened. Please, I beg of you, will you go and check? I have to know.
All right, I'll go.
Marvelous. Thank you. You'll be rewarded for your time, of course.
Whereabouts is she?
Gotan's Bales. It's on the outskirts of Lostwig. Not the safest place for an unaccompanied bearer, perhaps, but the soil there is second to none. Now go, and do not linger. Why, it may already be too late.
Damn it. We'll be needing more wood. But if I step away to fetch any, this lot will be down around our ears. Ah, you there. Perfect timing. I couldn't persuade you to fetch me some timber, could I? I'd be happy to. Oh, thank you. You'll be helping me and the hideaway both. Takes a lot of work to keep this place standing. More than we can manage, if I'm honest. It certainly looks like you've got your hands full. Ah, you can say that again. The Fallen knew their craft, make no mistake, but not even their handiwork lasts forever. That's why the walls need shoring up. Can't have the vegetable patch crushed before our first harvest now, can we? No, I suppose not. All right, where can I find this wood? Ask over at the White Ads. They'll point you in the right direction. Thanks again. I really appreciate the help.
Can we really do with a proper place of trade?
We're looking at half a dozen.
Excuse me. The man working over by the garden sent me to fetch some wood.
Ah, that'll be Geoffrey, Master Carpenter. Luck would have it, we've just finished cutting the timber he's after. You take as much as you need from the stack.
Thank you.
No, not at all. We appreciate the assistance.
Better get this to Geoffrey, was it?
Oh, you're back. Hope fetching that wood wasn't too much trouble.
Must be enough.
This will do nicely, thank you. With a bit of luck, the walls won't be falling in on us just yet.
That sounds ominous.
Oh, it's not as bad as all that. And it's a damn sight better than the alternative. We're safe, we're warm, and we're hidden. What more could we ask for? Now stop fretting and take this. You've earned it. Welcome to the fold.
There's no need to...
That's not a matter of need, my friend. You're one of us now.
just don't have enough teams to follow every lead.
No.
Ah, Clive. I trust you're settling in?
Gradually getting used to the place.
I'm glad to hear it. I was hoping you might be persuaded to come to my aid once more. Your services will be rewarded, of course.
I don't doubt it. Seems to be the way around here.
We strive to be better than those we once served. Now, as to the task itself, I am once again in need of a pair of hands to deliver sustenance to our esteemed companions. I have three meals for three industrious souls. What say you? It is simple work, and you'd be rewarded, of course. But I shan't presume to pressure you.
Someone's in trouble.
Would have been worse if you hadn't come along. Wait, I've seen you around the hideaway. You're new, aren't you?
I'm Clive.
And I'm Martel. But what are you doing here?
Looking for you. This is no place for a bearer on her own.
I noticed that. But this soil's not going to collect itself.
Then what if I gathered it for you? You could head back to the hideaway. Just exactly what sort of dirt is it that you need?
What I need is soil. But I'd be a fool to refuse your help after what just happened. It's the good stuff you're looking for. Dark, rich, fragrant. You'll know it when you find it.
Dark, rich, and fragrant. Right. Well, you should hurry back. Bohemil seemed worried enough that he might come looking for you himself.
That seems unlikely, but I won't argue with you. Thanks.
Soil, then. There's certainly enough of it here. But is it dark, rich, and fragrant? Should be enough. I better get it back to the hideaway.
There you are. And all safe and sound.
Well, yes, she's standing right there.
Not the girl. The soil. Did you bring it?
Yes. Here.
Glorious! When Martell came home empty-handed, I almost had a fit. But with this, my research can continue. First and foremost come the measurements. I must know how much ether each sample contains. From there...
Wait, so you were never...
Worried about me? Sorry to disappoint you, but the only thing he worries about is his research.
But that's...
That's all right. It's just how he is. And if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be growing anything in these ruins. It's a small price to pay. Although, you shouldn't have to pay it too. Did he even offer you anything for helping? Ugh. Here. I know it's not much, but it's something, at least. I wish I could offer you some fruit, too, but you're not likely to thank me if I do. Still, we'll grow something worth eating one of these days, and when we do, you'll have first pick.
Mind's made up, is it?
We'll be leaving for Rosaria as soon as we're able.
Back down memory lane, eh? Rosaria ain't what she used to be, Clive, and not since the Imperials moved in. First sign of trouble, you make straight for Martha's Rest and ask for the landlady. She's a friend of the cause. Tell her you're with Sid, and she'll help you out.
Understood. Thank you, Gav.
Yeah.
I'd be lost without you.
Yeah, I'm just doing my job. No need to make such a fuss. You take care, all right? Oh, I'm crap at goodbyes. Where's Sid when you need him?
Give him my regards when he gets back.
I will.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Ready, my lady?
Ready. Rosaria. It's been 13 years.
But this breeze, the smell of the grass, it's just as I remember it.
You haven't been back either.
I couldn't. Rand did keep a close watch on each other in the Imperial Army. You'd get beheaded just for knowing a deserter. The only way out was on a mission.
I see.
Mostly I was afraid. Afraid to go back.
I know.
But I'm here now. happens to you. We should press on. Martha's Rest. Gav said the landlady's a friend.
But can we say the same for her patrons?
Imperials don't tend to take well to those with my mark. If anyone asks, I'm a branded soldier, sworn to protect my noble mistress.